In the previous episode, we learned about the canonization and apocryphal books. In this episode, we will try to understand the ways by which the original text of scriptures were preserved without any kind of writing techniques and without any instruments, and also how the copies were made and available from the original text. The Old Testament was written in Hebrew language, and the New Testament was written in Greek language, a little Aramaic and Latin. It was a time when the writing technology or even the writing instruments were not easily available. Therefore, the written scrolls were preserved safely. Later on, these were translated to different languages. The Bible was initially spread to the society orally. Later, the written form of Bible came up. The scripture in the original languages are called as original text, and the scripture in other languages were known as translations. The original text of the Bible is not available today, but the copies of the same are available. So there were theologians or scribes who used to document everything by copying it from an original text. So scribes made copies and revealed the truth of the scriptures. So they were called as keepers of the home. The copies of the scriptures were made by the scribes when a chief scribe usually dictated. And then later in Deuteronomy 31 verses 24 to 26, we can see that God himself commanded to the people of Israel to keep the scriptures written by Moses, to keep it beside the Ark of Covenant in Holy of Holies. So Bible talks about preserving the scripture. The Levites were actually the in charge of the Ark of the Covenant and the scriptures which is kept beside it, and they were further directed to make copies of the original text for various uses. And we can read about it in Deuteronomy 17 verses 18 and 19. So in the ancient times, people used different methods to write things. Modern day papers were not available in those times. Therefore, people used parchment, scrolls made of animal skin, clay tablets, wooden tablets, paper made of papyrus plants for writing purposes. Papyrus plants were more in places like Syria and Egypt. The delicate layer of these plants were taken and are dried in bundles. Then the inner side is smoothened by plain stones or similar instruments, and this soft part is used instead of papers. The manuscripts of the Bible that are available today show the antiqueness of the scroll. It is believed that these manuscripts were written in between 2nd and 15th centuries. They were written in parchment or in papyruses. They are called by the name of the place from where it is actually found, or the name of the place where it was kept safe or preserved. So the name of the place is added as a prefix to the word codex. Codex means an ancient manuscript text or form of book. So there are a lot of manuscripts from which the current modern Bible is copied. Among them, the famous ones are Dead Sea Scrolls, Masoretic Text, Cairo Codex, Leningrad Codex, Aleppo Codex. So when we talk about these codex, the first and foremost codex was Dead Sea Scrolls, or a manuscript which was a breakthrough in the Christian as well as the archaeological world. This was the most ancient manuscripts that are retrieved so far. It was found in 1947. From a cave near Dead Sea, which is north to the Jericho. They were covered with linen cloths and were sealed in clay pots of 24 inch high and 10 inch wide. From the age of calculations of the clay pots, it is commonly believed that the scrolls are written around 125 BC. Almost all the manuscripts of Old Testaments were found in these. These texts were also known as Qumran scrolls, as these scrolls were preserved by the Qumran community. And the fun fact is, the name of the cave from these scrolls were found is Qumran Caves. And yeah, you can go and visit it in Israel. Major scrolls like Isaiah and some deuterocanonical books were also a part of this Dead Sea Scrolls. And also, since the internet era boomed up, you can go to deadseascrolls.org to see the actual scrolls which were found in there, which is open for every other person in the world. You can go in there, you can see the actual text written there, and you can understand the current Bible is actually translated from those scrolls. The second one is Masoretic Text, and it was the traditional text of the Hebrew Bible. It was revised and annotated by Jewish scholars or Jewish rabbi between the 6th and 10th century AD. A group of Jewish scribes made copies of the text. Masora means tradition. They wrote this with the help of different tradition. So that's how we got the name Masoretic Text. Majority of the current Bible is a copy of Masoretic text, and we often call it the original text. The third codex is Cairo Codex. So Moses ben Asher of Ben Asher family from Palestine wrote these manuscripts in AD 845. Prophetic books are included in this. So they were found in a synagogue at Cairo, Egypt. And then later we do have Leningrad Codex. These scrolls were retrieved in AD 916 and are kept in Saltykov Shchedrin Public Library. This contains all prophetic books except the Book of Daniel. Aleppo Codex. It is believed that it was written somewhere in 10th century or copied from Masoretic text. And it is the complete manuscript of Old Testament. The name Aleppo Codex was given to this as it was kept for around 500 years till 1948 in a synagogue at Aleppo, which is in Syria. From these, we can understand that the Old Testament text in the current modern Bible is a direct copy of the original text found in the manuscripts or codex, which also proves that the current modern Bible is a collection of the ancient scripts written by patriarchs mentioned in the Bible.